Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyirhu biyadihi, fa illam yastati' fa bi lisanihi, fa illam yastati' fa bi qalbihi, wa dhalika adhaful iman." The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Whoever sees an evil amongst you should change it with his hand, if he cannot so with his tongue, and if he cannot so with his heart. And this is the weakest of faith." In this hadith, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, taught his ummah that they are given a very noble job. They are supposed to be the people who enjoin good and forbid evil. The Holy Quran also praised this ummah because of this thing. The Holy Quran says, "Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat lin-nas ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar." You are the best nation evolved for mankind. You enjoin good and forbid evil. So it means that we are given this noble place in the sight of Allah, that Allah is calling us the best of all nations just because of this duty that we are doing Amr bil Ma'ruf wa Nahi anil Munkar. And according to this hadith, it's very clear that this duty is not given only to ulama. This duty is not given only to the government, that they have to stop the crimes and all the evil things. But Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is saying to every of his followers that you have to do this. According to our capacity, everyone is responsible to spread the goodness and to eradicate and to shun the evil. According to the teachings of Islam, if a person can stop the evil and he observes the evil happening, and even then he does not try to stop it, so he will be considered equal to the people in sin who are committing it. And there are evidences that Allah punished those who did not play this role in the community. Like, there is a hadith in which Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said that Allah ordered Angel Jibrail to destroy a particular township. Angel Jibrail said, "Ya Allah, there is a person who did not do the sins. So what should I do with him?" But Allah said that he will also be punished with the community, because my law was broken in front of him and he never tried to stop the people. So he is equal in sin with them. So that's why it is very important that whatever we can do, we have to do that to stop the evil in our community. The reason is that if we will not stop the evil on its earliest stage, it will grow very rapidly in the community. And then we will also be involved in it, and our generations will be involved in that evil. We cannot remain away from the bad effects of that evil. If a person has cleaned his house and he has thrown away all the trash outside his house and he thinks that my house is very clean, so obviously a wind will come and all the dirt will again come back into his house. We cannot remain clean and we cannot be pious until and unless our community is not clean and our community is not pure from sins. A person cannot remain pious and he cannot say that I am free from sins when in the community all around the evil is going on. Obviously we will be affected with those evils. So that's why the responsibility goes to all of us to play a role in purifying the community from all the evil practices. We have to condemn it and we have to stop it, whatever we can do for that. And how can we practice this? And this is the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, also mentioned the three types of jihad somehow. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "Stop the evil with your hand." It means that we have to do the physical jihad if it is required. And if we cannot do the physical jihad in some cases, so over there we have to use our speech. That is called mental jihad. We can do the counseling. And we can do the speeches at least to inform people about their mistake. And there are cases in which we cannot even say anything. So at least we should dislike it at our heart. And that will be called the spiritual jihad. So there are basically three main forms of jihad in Islam. The physical jihad, and mental jihad, and spiritual jihad, and all of them are somehow mentioned in this hadith. And how can we practice this hadith? You can say that there are some cases in which a person has authority and power. For example, the rulers. The rulers have all authorities and powers. They have the armies in their control, they have the police in their control, all the institutions come into practice and they become active on their command. So they are responsible to stop all the crimes and all the evil practices happening in the community using all of their authorities. They are answerable about it. Similarly, we can say that a father is authority case in a family unit. He should teach his wife and his children the good things, and he should ask them to stop the evil things. And in the case of the need of the use of authority, he can use his authority also. He can order them to stop some unlawful practice. He can do that because he is authority in a family. But there are cases in which we don't have any authority, like we have no authority on our friends, we have no authority on the neighbors, we have no authority on the other members of the community. Over there, we should do the mental jihad, like we should do the counseling, which we can at least inform them about their mistake. We can talk about all different things with our friends. So why can't we talk with them about the sins they are committing? Why we cannot ask them to stop those evil things from their life? So the Holy Quran also says that about the qualities of believers, that watawasaw bil haqqi watawasaw bis sabr. They enjoin haqq to each other, they teach goodness to each other, and they ask each other to be patient on the obedience of Allah. So that is called the mental jihad, and we should do that. And we will not be held responsible on the judgment day if we have informed the people about their mistake. Whether they stop it or not, it's their job. Allah will ask them about their actions. But our responsibility will be over when we will say that this thing is wrong and this thing should be stopped. But if we will not even say, and if we will remain quiet, so then we will also be held responsible on the judgment day, and Allah will ask us that when this thing was happening, what you were doing and why you were not playing your role in the community. But there are some cases in which we cannot even say. Sometime a person does not have that much knowledge. Sometime a person is not in the position to say anything. Maybe sometime he has the life threats also. So in that case, a person should at least dislike it at heart. He should at least pray for the guidance of the people who are committing that evil. And he should remain away from that evil practice. That will be his spiritual jihad at that time. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, called it the least level and the lowest level of a faith to dislike something evil. But when a person comes into that stage, that when evil is going on in front of him and he does not even dislike it, it means that the faith is gone. He is not even on the lowest rank of Iman. May Allah save us from being on that level of Iman and to be out of Iman. And may Allah give us the courage to play our role in the community, to spread the goodness and to shun the evil. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. الله